One of the biggest problems a lot of traders face is how to draw proper market structure, and hence they find it difficult to find proper highs, proper lows, and know which of the highs and lows to take in drawing market structure. In this video, I am going to be showing you a tool that shows you market structure without you having to lift a finger and do the hard work. You don't have to look for highs and lows by yourself. You don't have to determine whether or not it was broken. You just need to understand how this indicator works, and you have everything you're looking for. This video is dedicated to a subscriber of mine, Jesse Tumi, who asked the question of how to use this specific indicator I'm going to teach you in this video. So if you're watching this video and you have questions to ask, do well to drop it in the comments, and also hit the like, the thumb ups, and share this video to somebody who you think might enjoy the Forex education. Not just Forex, it's a trading education because it applies on every trading chart. Without further ado, let's dive into this. I think I've mentioned this multiple times on my channel. People have heard me say it multiple times but never really took notice of what it was. It is called the ZigZag indicator. So what really is the ZigZag indicator? The ZigZag indicator is a technical analysis tool that just shows you all the highs and lows based on the deviation of price you set it to. Let's take a good look at the technical, definition. The ZigZag indicator is a technical analysis tool used in trading to filter out minor price fluctuations or market noise and highlight significant price trends and reversals. It helps traders visualize the underlying market structure by connecting only the most important swing highs and swing lows. So just like I said in the layman terms, it's a tool that shows you highs and lows, but again, it is based on your very own settings. Now, a lot of people are looking for shortcuts to understanding structure and other stuff. I already had a video where I explained how to draw structure by yourself. But if you're still finding it difficult, then this tool is absolutely going to help you out of the water. But take note, this tool is a lagging indicator. Just like many indicators in the market, most of them are lagging indicators. What do we mean by indicators? Well, these are indicators that only tell you what price has done. For example, the moving averages. For moving average to be calculated, price ought to have already moved. So it will take that move that has happened and then add it to its current calculator and then divide it by all the averages which you asked it for. For example, you could set it to 200, 10, 20, 29, 15, 21, 9, name it. It's always going to wait for price to make moves, close out, and then it's going to take the price move, add it to its summation, and divide it by the total time frame you set it with. Same thing with this indicator, but unlike a moving average, this doesn't look for averages. It's looking for percentage changes. What is this indicator used for basically? It is used to identify trends, because if it can tell you price changed at a certain percentage, it can tell you, okay, price keeps changing at a certain percentage, up or down. You can identify the trend of the market just by looking at that. The next thing is it filters noise, just like they said. So those moves, those very tiny move in between that percentage movement, they are all noise. When it comes to this indicator, they are all regarded as noise. It can be used to identify support and resistance. So for price to move significantly a certain percentage from a certain location. So for example, price made a high and then suddenly moved 10% down. It means at that high, there's obviously a very strong amount of resistance. And if price should do the opposite thing on the low, get to a certain low, and then suddenly boost up by 10%. It means there's a lot of support at that low. Meaning when price comes back around that area, there's high tendency that people are also going to buy there. You can also use this to spot chart pattern. Now, unlike the moving average, which just draws a straight line like this, this one draws the line following the price fluctuation. Hence, because you can see that line, you can then, visually see those price patterns. These are for people who trade pattern trading. For example, people who trade the QM arrow QMC, which is the Quasimodo reversal, Quasimodo continuation, price fluctuation, even market structure traders, because market structure is actually price pattern too. Ups, higher highs, higher lows, lower lows, lower highs. is price pattern. So you get to see that pattern clearly on the chart thanks to this indicator. The next is it can tell you entry and exit points and also stop loss and take profit areas based on your understanding of the indicator. Without further ado, let's head into the chart where I will show you exactly how this indicator works, how to use it, and then how to apply it to your very own situation. So right here, we have a daily chart of the Australian dollar against the Swiss franc. And on every broker, you should be able to find, the ZigZag indicator. For example, even on Meta 4, Meta 5, you should be able to find it. All you need to go to is click your indicator and you click on the ZigZag. Now, the sweet thing with the ZigZag indicator, it is very, very similar to the William Fractal indicator. The only difference is William Fractal only shows you the highs and lows and nothing else. While the ZigZag draws clear lines between those highs and those lows. It connects the highs and lows. That way you can see the movement without having to recalculate over and over again using the Fractal. So in this case, what we're looking at here is this setting is set to 5% deviation and 5 candle depth. What does this mean? So 5% deviation means if price moves 5% away from a high or a low, it starts to print a new pattern. That means it starts to tell you price is moving in a certain new direction, at least 5%. And then depth, same thing as depth across every other trading platform and every other indicator. It's calculating 5 candles in this case. So if price has moved 5%, it's going to wait for price to make 5 candles after that percentage for it to say, okay, it has finally come to say that this is its current new low or high position. And then it gives you that line telling you, okay, we have a new line 5% away from it. So you can do well to set your depth to 1. You can set it as many as possible. Now let's dive into utilizing it for personal use. In my opinion, to answer Jetsumi's question, I'd say the best way you can use this indicator is to actually use it double layered. So for example, I'm trading the daily time frame and this indicator is currently set to 5. I'm seeing very, very huge swings. It's taking at least, let's say, this is where it changed the first time. And it took at least how many days? This is about 247 days before it made the next low of 5%. Let's see how long away from the previous one. So it also took about 57 days for it to make a new 5% deviation high. So we can't be waiting 58 days before we know a high is made. Which of course, take note, is it has to also count another 5 candles forward. So that would be like 58 plus 5, making it 63 days. So you have to literally wait 63 days to see it tell you, oh, we just made a new high, or oh, we just made a new low. That's a lot. So using this to print out market structure on the higher and the lower time frame is what it is used for. For example, this particular stuff being shown here is most likely telling me the monthly or weekly structure of the market, because let's check it out. If we go up to the weekly, you can see it takes a long, it becomes smaller because it's not taking account of that 5% change. And now take note, 5% change in price in a week is not a lot, but for price to move 5% in a day, that is a lot. Let's take a good look at this. I want you to take your eyes to the top right, top left corner of the screen where we have the open, high, low, close and volt percentage deviation and also price movement. I actually like to see that whole information there. You can see price moved by, over here, price moved by 6.11% in a week. Take note, these are weekly candles in 1 week. Now that is a huge move in 1 week. So if 6.11% is a huge move in 1 week, then you looking for 5% on the daily time frame is you looking for too much. Meaning finding 5% in just 1 day, that is absolutely wild. So what does that mean? It means I'm going to look at all these candles one after the other, and I'm going to say, what is the average move? And that's where ATR comes in, but I do not want to use ATR in this video. That will be a separate video. You're going to look at this recent sets of candle, and let's say you could take a look at like five, since you're using five candles, you can take a look at five candles, right? So we have 0.18, 0.25, 0.1. So we have another 1%, 1%, 1%. So we have about 1.5%. So if you're trading anything way below the lower time frame, below the daily time frame, for example, you're trading the 1 hour, right? Trading the 1 hour. It means to know the higher time frame move, you need to set this to about 1%. And at 1%, you can see how it's already telling me the possible daily moves. When price moves 1%, it tells me that is like a huge move on the daily. So what I'm looking at right here is all of this move right here, all of this move right here is telling me that price is moving way harder than 1% already. And hence, you should start looking for possibly new moves. Meaning, you should start looking for possibly reasons to buy or setting up a sell stance if you want to take a sell. This is on the 1 hour, take note. So, to make it easier and sweeter for you, what you can do is understand what they call fractals. The trading is all about fractal. The chart is all about fractal. What are fractals? If you draw this move, let's say price made an up, high, low, high, right? This is the higher time frame move. On the lower time frame, you're going to be seeing price making moves like this. For sure, this is what you're going to see. You're going to be seeing the structure like this. So at every given point in time, on the lower time frame, price is making multiple ups and down, multiple higher structure, higher time frame, lower, multiple higher highs and lower lows, higher lows and lower lows on their own time frame. So what it means is to trade this, right? To trade this, because you have spotted that deviation. Let's just make it move a little bit. So because you spotted that enough deviation has occurred, and then you need to look at the lower time frame structure immediately. What you do is you would create a second zigzag indicator and you make it lower than the already existing one. So this is one. The sweet thing about this indicator is you can take it all the way to 0.001. So you just take it down to 0.5, which is half the higher time frame move. And now you have yourself a lower time frame structure to look out for. If the structure is way too steep for you, you can also play it down a little bit. This way you get to see more lower time frame structure and see if the price is moving. Now price is beginning to move up. On the lower time frame, what do we have? We have price breaking this high and price breaking this high. So naturally we expect market structure, higher high, higher lows, higher high, higher lows. We've already made the first higher high, higher low. So currently we are hoping to make a higher low and then move towards making a higher high. Already we have predicted the next set of movements we hope to see in the market. Take note, the key word here is hope. We do not know what the market does. We only hope what the market is going to do. So in this market, this is what you're going to be hoping for next. And you're hoping for it to continue in that direction to end up printing a higher time frame, possibly a good up move towards the side to a good extent, before you start to see reasons to follow the trend for a lower time frame sell. So again, this is how you can use market structure on the higher time frame to trade without having to go through multiple things. And this is how you can use zigzag indicator to trade higher time frame and lower time frame structure immediately without having to switch time frames too much. For my particular person, if you're trading a way lower time frame, you can set it as low as maybe the higher time frame zigzag indicator should be probably 0.5 and the lower time frame should be 0.1, 0.09. percent deviation. That way you get to see the smaller structure within the higher time frame structure, and you also see the higher time frame structure, and you know when you are falling into premiums and discount zones on the higher time frame to then know you should be cutting off trades or you should start switching your bias. With this, I hope you understand this ZigZag indicator, how to use it, how to apply it to your own very daily life trading, and get to understand the little bits of nuances. If you have further questions, drop it down in the comments. I'm very active. I'll reply to every single comment. And if you have questions on other indicators you think and you feel is absolutely valuable to you, do want to also drop it in the comment. We'll do research on it, figure out how it works, and see if it can be applied to the strategies we use. For supply and demand traders, this is absolutely a good reason right here to start aiming for reasons to buy in this market. With this, I'd like to say thank you all for watching and catch you all on another one. Peace.